Hello everyone, good evening and welcome to the 40th session that we are having together. And this will be, as I think you know, it is based on para-completion. Para-completion, you might also say, you know, fill with sentences. These sentences are left out at the end of the paragraph or at the beginning of paragraph. I'm not doing a mic check. I think I can see that I am audible. So I'll just proceed with it. I will let you know something about, you know, today's class. As we proceed, you know, just the agenda, you know, as I always show you, what we are going to discuss is understand the approach and solve some question by discussion. You know, today is going to be a bit different. This topic, you know, warrants discussion, because if I give you just my perspective, it will not help you. What I expect from you guys is, you know, go through the question, then think over it. Just not, you know, try to mark the correct answer. What is more important here is to understand why you will not mark other three or four choices as correct. That should be our aim here, okay? Now, I think I did not mention this point when, you know, we were taking my class day for yesterday, I believe, which was, you know, people saying, sir, these are long sentences and it's not worth one mark. Please remember, they are for mains. In mains, you have 40 minutes for English and only 35 questions. There is no way you will be leaving even a single question. Today, what is our target? In 15 minutes, we try to attempt, you know, 25 questions. Now, you are given, you know, almost three times, you know, the time and just 10 extra questions that we ask you to attend. So, you will be doing all RCs, you will be doing all sentence completion, you will be doing all sentence filler. And for that, you will have to have very good, you know, say reading habit. Even if you do not have great reading habit, you trust me, within the time, you know, given to you, you will be able to do all the questions. So that will not be a problem. What is more important is developing a very good vocabulary and diverse reading habit. I think, you know, yesterday Abhishek sir mentioned about, you know, how important it is to develop some good habits. Today, I'll just stress on one point, which is giving importance to English. Why we have been harping on this, you know, continuously prodding you to please go back and, you know, develop good reading habit. What is our intention? Of course, you know, you develop a good say language skill, which will always help you. And in this global world today, when, you know, everyone is looking for, you know, more interconnections in the global economy, you will need English, you know, you will need good command over English going forward. You guys are going to become probationary officers who will be leading various branches and banks, etc. There will be, you know, some elegant customers, well-read customers who will also come and visit you. And just think the kind of impression they will carry, you know, if you are not able to speak properly to them in English. So just not for yourself, for the reputation of bank also, you will need all this. And today's question, when you look at these questions that we are going to discuss today, they are from IBPS PO and SBI PO mains. Both appeared in say mains. And I think this is the first time they were introduced. For you know, for CAT, it was there from a long time. I think even in 2008, I have taken four questions for the CAT, which I appeared. So we'll see all those questions and you will understand the importance of reading habit. Now, why I say, you know, we need discussion, that also I will let you know. Let me just go straight forward. Okay, I'll just move out and, you know, I'm really happy today that we are, you know, almost done with almost all. So I can put a big tick mark here and we are just left with the five questions of sentence connection after today's class, which is taking care of the sentence fillers. Okay. Now, let me just take you through the approach first. Okay, let me just come back. I'll give you some gyan on how do we approach these questions, which is very simple. You know, the gyan part here is really very simple. I'll give you all the four, you know, try to understand. First step in these questions would be try to understand what the paragraph is all about. Author might be trying to say altogether something very different, okay? Please try to understand, we have to be focused on only those four or five lines which are given to us. Try to comprehend its meaning in full. What does it try to convey? Next is the structure and scope. How is, you know, is it talking about the problem only in Delhi? The last line then cannot be a global solution. That is the meaning of structure and scope that we want to emphasize here. if you look at those four lines, they might be talking about some very specific, or if they are talking about general problem per se, then the solution cannot be of the problem facing in Bihar. All right. So the structure and the theme, how the paragraph is progressing, has to be very important. You have to understand that. Third is the author's mood or, you know, tone. That is very, if he has written all four, five lines which are positive, the fifth line cannot be an anticlimax. Please try to understand, this is very important. You can eliminate some options directly. So you have to understand that. Finally, last line and continuity becomes very important, but these are, you know, some questions wherein you will have those missing lines even from the paragraph. So just look, what is its continuity to? So if a line is missing here, what is the next line talking about? They cannot be far apart, okay? So with that idea, we will start, but try to understand, this is, you know, not very simple topic. So, you know, at the outset, I will set the expectation very clear. There might be times where, you know, my opinion would be different from yours, and maybe the examining body has altogether different opinion. So that is something that I want to start with. This is a famous exam. I am not naming the name of the I am not taking. I am just giving you this question. Please go through it. I'll give you some 30 seconds to go through it. Till that, I will just read your comments and then come back. Please try to attempt this question. You have to give me the last line for this question. Okay, so I have just come back on screen to say something. As I mentioned, I just do not want your answers today. I also want your explanation. Okay, so if you are marking two, please give me in one line why you are, you know, choosing two over other options. Otherwise, this session is, you know, useless. What I can do is, you know, I will say, okay, you know, clearly this one is not, you know, making sense here. Two, okay, it's out of the context. 3 seems okay, let me check 4 and 5, of course not suiting here. I can also explain like that, right? It does not, you know, what I have been trying in all these English sessions especially is try to get into the mind. I can understand how difficult it is when you start with the English paper. Try to give you solid reason for eliminating. I try my level best, maybe I am, you know, not very successful in doing it. Please try to understand, once you get hang of language, getting the correct answer is not such a problem. Explaining why others are not is the real challenge. Okay, for our learning purpose here, please give me your explanation as to why you are choosing. I see a lot of twos. I do not know how you are getting that. I need to see all those who are marking two. Please give me an explanation. I do not want you to Google these paragraphs and give me the answer. Please give me the answer with logic. Bhim says, please remove yourself from screen. I was off the screen. I came to, you know, discuss the answer. Meaning of furtive is, you know, avoid, you know, noticing, you know, an attention. जब आप किसी को चोरी छिपे देखते हो या इस तरह से अगर करते हो, आप नहीं चाहते हो कि वो आपको वापस देखे. That's furtive look. Okay, now suddenly I am not getting the answer from, I am interested, three I can understand because that is what even I would have marked. In fact, that is what I also marked when, you know, I appeared for CAT 2008. I want to know from people whom, or five also I can understand. In fact, I was confused between three and five. I want to, you know, take, I want to see the opinion of the guys who went ahead with two. If they had not tried to Google it, what was their logic? Ayush has interesting, 1, 2, 5 are out of scope, 3 is negative and so answer should be 4. Okay, I think valid point, but please see that, you know, overall tone is not positive, Ayush, if that was the name, if I have not. Unblemished is, you know, something which is not spoiled, not damaged, etc. Okay, I suddenly do not get any response from people who marked 2. That was the idea, right? First of all, please try to understand, the entire session will be like this. I would like to understand your opinion, why you are marking what you are marking. If somebody has problem, can leave right away. I do not want to see any comment like, you know, ki kya ho raha hai sir aur ye sab. So, ye pura ka pura session, it will be going on like this. We will discuss, we will try to understand logic. Please spend time on what is getting written on your chat box. Please try to see what others are thinking, and that is how we will develop a knack for it. Okay, I hope I am clear in my communication. Okay, I still don't have any, you know, all I at least saw 8 or 10, I do not remember their name, 8 or 10 people who marked 2. Peroni, yes, Henry Peroni is his name, yes, if that is how he wants to pronounce his name, yeah, that is his name. Okay, very good. I can clearly make out all those twos where all those who tried to Google the answer, and you know, I'll just show you the paragraph and, you know, tell you something very interesting. Now read, this is from New Yorker. Please try to read the entire passage. I'll give you some 30 seconds for it, and then you will understand why those guys who were marking 2 were marking it but had absolutely no clue about why 2 should be the answer. Please read it and then I'll tell you something more interesting, and that is why, you know, I have put this question in the beginning. There is some reason why I have done it. Please read it and then I'll come back again. Okay, someone asked the meaning of pallor. Pallor is pale in appearance, nearly, you know, white. So maybe he's talking about the American doctor without having any blemish in his hand, you know, any cut or any sign which talks about, you know, how skilled he is, that, you know, even after operating for years, he does not have even a single cut mark. I think that is what they want to refer. And I think Gautam says that he did not Google his answer. Gautam, I'm not accusing anyone. Please try to understand. I want to understand. What went through your mind? Okay, now if you look at this, you can clearly see that, you know, when I also took test, I marked 3. When I came back, I googled, I tried to Google, and I was really disappointed. I thought I have got it wrong. You know, downward glance, other patient do not like. other patient don't know, don't like what they see but are ignorant of their right to go elsewhere. Some note the hand but are placated by the reputation or don't give a damn. And there are still others who notice nothing or feel nothing or are unable to communicate owing to cognitive impairment that has brought them in the first place. Okay. Now this seems like, you know, your option 2 is correct, right? But please try to see, this does not complete the sentence. And I was very happy, you know, Cat also gave third as answer. Even if you try to Google it today, most of the coaching institute have still stuck with this because they also tried to Google and mark the answer. Cat went ahead with this. You can check on TG, Tathagata or Total Gadha, I think a reputed site for, you know, Cat preparation, and they have mentioned it. And I, as far as I remember, because this question was really close to my getting selected, one question here and there and you are in and out. So I think I got this right. And now I will tell you what is the reason why I took this question for discussion. Okay. Now, you know, let me just come back on screen. I'll you know, explain it in detail also. What I wanted to convey with this question is you have to see those four or five lines which are given to you in context of those three and four lines and not use your extra information or, you know, judge all these four lines with, you know, any other thing. With the information given in hand, whatever is, you know, presented to you, can you get down to answer? That is what is required in, you know, these questions. So I think that is the theme. I hope I have made that clear. Now I'll explain to you what this sentence was written. Trust me, the level, if you think that this is, and the famous exam that I've been talking about is nothing but CAT 2008. I have taken four questions from there. You will see other four also. And if you think that, you know, these are CAT level difficulty, trust me, there is a paragraph you know, in I think IBPS third or fourth question, which talks about Immanuel Kant, who is the, you know, famous philosopher from Germany. You read his paragraph. I have also given you the link from where that paragraph is taken. I will, you know, I do not have words to say. Please try to summarize what he has written in 250 words or take 300 words. If you can do that, you know, by reading that in less than, you know, 5 or 10 attempts, I'll be really happy for you. That means you are doing a good job. So that is a level of difficulty where even all our bank exams have already reached. So don't think that we are, you know, anyways out of context here. Okay. Now with that, let me just move on and I'll try to explain this question to you and what went in my head, why I wrote what I wrote, and, you know, I'll explain what is going on here. This is the level of English, guys, which you are expected to understand now. That is the key message here. Okay. Now let me try to explain you what is going on here. Okay. Now, most people at their first consultation take a furtive look at the surgeon's hand in hope of reassurance. So what is happening here? All these guys who are coming to the surgeon, they are looking a furtive look. Wo kya kar rahe hain? They are looking at his hand. Unke haath ko chori chupi dekhne ki koshish kar rahe hain ki aapko pata hai isi haath se wo aapka wo cheer phaad karne wala hai. To aap dekhna chahte ho yaar uska haath kahin shake to nahi kar raha, uska haath sab theek thaak to hai. That is what you are trying to reassure yourself ki at least his hands are good enough, delicate, it is sophisticated, it has no cut marks, etc. That is what, you know, aap chori chori, you know, with those hidden glances, you want to assure yourself that is happening. Prospective patient look for delicacy, sensitivity, steadiness, perhaps unblemished pallor. Pallor kya bataya tha aapko? Pale appearance. And unblemished was undamaged. So, uska jo haath agar wo gora hai, agar he is from America, to uske haath mein kahin par bhi koi cut mark wagera nahi hai. Ye aap dekhna chahte ho, uska haath thar tharata wagera nahi hai. This is what you want to assure yourself. Okay? On this basis, Henry Perrone loses a number of cases each year. Iska matlab kya ho raha hai? What is happening here? The criteria for, you know, all these things which people generally look when they come to him are not being met in Henry Perrone, and he is losing few cases. Now, generally he knows it, it's about to happen before the patient does. Wo kya hota hai? He gets to know that the patient will ultimately not stick with him, but they will go. And how does he know all about it? The downward glance repeated. So kya hota hai? Patient na uska haath dekhte hain aur baar baar dekhte rehte hain. To aap chori chori dekhna chahte ho to kya karoge? Aap ek do baar dekhoge. But uske haath mein kuch aisa hai, you are, aap apne aap ko rok nahi pa rahe ho, baar baar dekh rahe ho. Okay? You are looking at it repeatedly. The prepared questions beginning to falter. Aap doctor ke paas jaate ho to kya hota hai? What happens generally? You have set of prepared questions, right? आप जानते हो कि डॉक्टर को एक बार जब मिलने जाते हो 500 रुपए लगेंगे, तो यार ये 8-10 क्वेश्चन है, फटाफट डॉक्टर से सब पूछ लो, ठीक है? क्योंकि आप एक बार कैबिन से बाहर निकल जाते हो, 20-25 पेशेंट और हो जाते हैं, देन यू डोंट गेट टू आस्क हिम ऑल द क्वेश्चन, आप फिर टेंसी वापस लौटते हो, ठीक है? अब इसमें क्या होता है, व्हाट हैपेंस इज द प्रिपेयर्ड क्वेश्चन बिगनिंग टू फॉल्टर. अब क्या होता है कि जब आप उसके हाथ पे ये देखते हो, यू आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद दिस हैंड, वो चाहे जो भी कारण है अभी तक उसके बारे में नहीं बताया है, तो उसके बाद क्या होता है आपका प्रिपेयर्ड क्वेश्चन ना, अब आपको लगता है यार इससे तो मेरे को सर्जरी करानी ही नहीं है, तो योर प्रिपेयर्ड क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो बिगिन टू फॉल्टर. आप ना वो पूछने में कंफर्टेबल नहीं रहते हो क्योंकि अब आपको उससे कोई मतलब ही नहीं है, राइट. एंड The over emphatic thanks during the retreat to door. तो क्या होता है, जनरली आप थैंक यू सर बोल करके जाते हो, लेकिन इसमें क्या होता है जब वो डोर से जब आप दूर जब जा रहे होते हैं तो अब आपको पता है इसके पास दोबारा नहीं लौटना, तो इसको चलो कम से कम खुश करके जाते हैं, हाँ सर एकदम झुक करके उसको बहुत प्रोफ्यूजली यू ट्राई टू थैंक हिम एंड यू नो यू गो आउट, ऑल राइट, दैट इज यू नो यू थैंक वाइल यू रिट्रीट टू डोर. जब ये ऐसा होता है देन द डॉक्टर ही नोज फॉर श्योर दीज गाइज आर नॉट कमिंग बैक, क्योंकि उसके हाथ को देख रहा था. एंड यू नो यू हैव रेड द एंटायर पैसेज ऑल्सो, क्योंकि उसका हाथ काफ़ी बड़ा है और इस वजह से ये ऐसा हो रहा है, ठीक है. और उसके बाद उसमें और भी काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें लिखी हुई थी कि यू नो कुछ पेशेंट को पता ही नहीं होता है कि यहाँ से और दूर जा सकते हैं, कुछ को क्योंकि वो दिमागी रूप से बीमार है, इज अ न्यूरो सर्जन आई बिलीव, तो उनको आते ही दिमाग के प्रॉब्लम की वजह से है, तो दे आर नॉट बॉदर्ड ओनली कि वो इतना दिमाग लगा पाएं कि उसका हाथ कैसा है. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स English also I am explaining, I am trying to explain in Hindi also because a lot of people who will find problem will be also from Hindi. This you know forces me to explain few points in Hindi. You are not losing on anything, please try to understand. I am trying to accommodate both because these are really tough passages. You know it's not it would be you know expecting really too much from guys who have you know very limited understanding of English as a language. So please try to accommodate here. I will be speaking a few lines in Hindi off and on also. Okay, so that is the problem here, and therefore, you know, with the context of passage, all the four lines which are given to us, what I can say is, you know, in spite of all that is happening, Perone himself is not concerned, is what I can give. Though option two looks like a correct answer when you know read the entire thing. Other people do not communicate due to their poor observation. You know, it is not a bad choice here. You know, some of them are going, some of them are still sticking. But still, if you look at what is the context, what has been talked about, it is talking about the concerns. It is talking from the point of view of the surgeon. And the best possible answer that I can give here is Perone himself is not concerned, though many people are going. And all those who were, you know, going, why you cannot mark 5? These hand, but how do you know they are large? You know, it could be small also, it could be too small, or it could be shaky, or you know, it could be any other thing. So that makes the choice for 3 good enough. And why are we eliminating choice 4? You know, this could be very well a thought. I have absolutely no problem with those who tried to mark this, and their point of view was he loses and he thinks that you know others will fulfill. If you look at the meaning, contextual meaning of 3 and 4 are almost same, but going with 3 is if you looked at the passage, entire passage, this is what was mentioned, you know, one line after that, right? So why I will conclude with 3 and not 4 is he is not talking more, he is not concerned about business per se, what will come. What I can, you know, gaze from these 4-5 lines is he's not concerned about what is happening at that time, at this very moment right now. I hope, okay. So I am, yes, I thought 4, yes, all those who thought 4, I can sympathize with you because he's thinking about his future business is what you are concerned about. But with these 4 lines, I will be more concerned about what is happening in this current scenario and what is his feeling towards it. That is why I will eliminate 4. Okay? Yes, option 4 is an assumption. I think, that he's thinking about his future business. But here, you know, this goes in context what is already mentioned here, that, you know, few people are leaving and he's really not bothered about them. Okay? Okay, good. With this, I have just given you a glance of, you know, the kind of question that can come. We will slowly move into our actual exam question, SBI PO main. I'll just give me the answer. I think this one we discussed elaborately in, you know, our sentence filler. Please try to solve this for me. And then give me the reasons now. I'm more interested in your reason why you are eliminating, or you know, if you are choosing something, why you are choosing it. I'll just, you know, kind of talk about, people are still talking about option 4. Option 4, again, it's presumptuous. You know, there is no information given about what he's thinking about his future business. What is already been mentioned about is he's losing few cases, why he is losing it, and hence option 3 follows because he is not concerned about people leaving him and going. If you actually go and read the real passage, option 2 should ideally be the correct choice here, right? But with all the information that is provided to you, option 3 is the best suited answer. Now, Shubham says, this will come with practice, Shubham. You know, more you read, more intuition you develop. I know you will not find this a great or a convincing answer, but that is how it happens. You have to see from the context what is most suited in given those 4 lines is what you have to pick. You have to eliminate anything that goes beyond the scope of those 4 or 5 lines which are given to you. Here he is thinking about future business, which was really out of context here. Guys, I do not want the answer. Please try to understand the this will be a useful class only if we are able to discuss few things. If I just give you what is there in my mind, I already know all the answers. And I have done some research over it. I can also tell you what I initially thought, but that will not help you really. I want to know what is going in your mind that will benefit your fellow students, that, you know, these are the things that can cross your mind and how you can eliminate them. That is the purpose of today's class. Otherwise, if you ask me, it'll just take me 20-30 minutes. I can just tell you, I'll convince you also with my logic. At the end of the day, either you will like my logic or not like my logic. That is what will happen. But what is the purpose of having this class is to understand what are the possible choices and the reason behind that. The more possible reasons that we get, more fruitful this class will be. So please give me the appropriate reason, that is, you know, the reason why you are choosing these answers. Please do that for me and for the benefit of class. Jivansh, I have already mentioned this. What kind of approach should be there to solve this kind of question? First, you have to develop a very good reading habit. Second, you have to read and understand those 4-5 lines given and not go over and beyond the scope of those 4-5 lines which are given to you. Please try to understand it. Even if the actual passage had anything, you know, might have been different, please try to see all these examiners. Know that you do not know the entire passage. They do not expect you. It is not reading comprehension test. You have to comprehend and give a logically correct answer which you can justify with logic that will actually follow. Okay, please try to solve like that. I see no answers now. Why is that a problem? Let me see. Okay, I am now getting few reasons. Okay, let me just read a few of your comments. I'll just go on mute. I'll just read your comments. Okay, guys, I hope you are reading the comments which others are also writing. Please try to understand. The value will come only from this. If you feel that, please don't get adamant on your thought. If you feel someone has really written a good point, try to build on it. Okay. Now, let me try to help you with this question. I think we discussed this elaborately earlier also. And this was the hint for this passage. You know, the business is instead moving to digital native insurance. So what does this mean? Your first part has to talk about something which is not digital, or, you know, the old, the traditional method is what is generally talked about here. Now, the growing mountain of personal data available to individual and crucially to the firm is giving those with necessary processing power the ability to distinguish between low risk and high risk individual. First, let me give you the context of this passage. This passage is talking about how the insurance industry is changing, or, you know, how the advent of technology is changing the face of insurance industry and who will be the ultimate winner in this industry. Okay. Now, business is instead moving to digital native insurer is what is talked about. So you can you not just guess what will come here? So what will come here is not the digital part, but the traditional part will come here. Just look at the options here. You know, it is again talking about the digital aspect. Cheap sensors and tsunami of data they generate can improve our life. Black boxes in car can tell us how to drive more carefully, and wearable devices again talks about the technological firm. The better behavior resulting from smart devices is just one of the threats to insurance industry. Now see, they are talking about the insurance. Conventional risk pools for home and car insurance are shrinking as preventable accident decline, leaving the slow-footed giant of the industry at risk. This is talking about the thing which is not digital. This is talking about the traditional method. Please try to understand here. This is the traditional method that they are trying to talk about. The uncertainty that underpins the need for insurance is now shrinking thanks to better insights to individual. Again, what is it talking about? Again, talking about all the uncertainty that can be, you know, moved from the individual to from by the use of technology. The data has again enabled something to move. Data has enabled insurance company to gauge the situation and plan accordingly. Again, this is not the case. Now, if you read this carefully, what is happening now, what it is slowly saying, and there is an interesting word here which talks about helicopter parent. What is helicopter parent? In that case, it will be C and D. Okay, I'll discuss C and D. Let's first discuss insurance is increasingly reliant on the use of technology to change behavior. Firms act as helicopter parents. What is a helicopter parent? Jo parent aapke sar pe mandra rahe hote hain, right? If you see the next line, you can immediately guess the meaning also. This is guessing the meaning in context. Helicopter parents to policyholder, warning of impending harm. Slow down, reduce your sugar intake, call the plumber, the better to reduce unnecessary payout. So helicopter parents are also like these, you know, they are constantly over your head and trying to warn you of the impending danger or things that you are doing wrong. That is a very interesting word, helicopter parent. Okay, so they are acting like, yet this sort of relationship relies on trust. So what is taking it is good. All these insurance, conventional insurance companies are helping us out. They try not with the only intention of helping us, but also because their payouts will decrease. That is why they are trying to behave like a helicopter parent. But this is more based on trust. Why do we listen to our parent? Because we trust them. We know that they will be ultimately talking about our good. And if the trust is the factor, then Google and Apple of the world, on which consumer rely day and day and hour by hour, may be best place to win the business. So who might end up losing here are those, the traditional industries, because they are also acting as helicopter parents. They are constantly warning you. Now in my daily day-to-day life, and it is all about trust, and if I have to believe someone, I will be more reliant on those who are helping me, right? Someone like Google and Apple is a company which I'll be more reliant on rather than the conventional LIC, right? They give me, I don't even get any message from them, even if I'm a policy holder of LIC. But, you know, they will be constantly in their warning letter, etc., or in their clause, etc., all those things will be mentioned. But Google and Apple are there guiding me real time. They give me navigation. They tell me what the weather would be like tomorrow. Should I carry an umbrella or not? All these things are actually building the trust. So ultimately you will see that this entire industry, the insurance, all those old industry, they might lose their business, and Googles and Apples of this world might get into insurance industry. If you look at the data has enabled insurance company to gauge the situation and plan accordingly, then where is the contrast? Business is instead moving to digital insurance. Can this line follow E? Just read this. The data has enabled insurance company to gauge situation and plan accordingly. Business is instead moving to digital native insurer. And therefore, the business is moving to digital insurer would be a better line, right? Now, between C and D, anyhow, I have eliminated A and B. B, I have clearly told you what should be the correct start. The data has enabled insurance company to gauge the situation and plan accordingly. And therefore, business is moving to native digital insurer. And still, it does not talk about the native digital insurer. What it is talking about is business is instead moving to digital native insurer. That means, who are we talking about here are the traditional people. Now my choice is between C and D, as rightly pointed out by people. The uncertainty that underpins the need for insurance is now shrinking thanks to better insight to individual risk. Business is instead moving to, then again this is continuation, right? Again, this instead word does not go with this. Please try to understand. The time pressure is not there. Please try to understand. There is no time pressure in mains. You have 40 minutes for 35 questions. These are questions in mains. This is not for prelims. Please try to understand that. I think Rahul Anand, please read his explanation. He is given just right. This is what I have been trying to mention. This digital native insurer, instead of them, so you have to contrast it with someone. Who are those? Are those slow footed or the traditional insurers who we are talking about? It says even after finding out the answer, please read all the options. If you want my suggestion, please try to read all the options, which is very important. If you just read one of the options and you feel that is the correct, you might get it wrong. Please read all five options and then choose the best among them. D, uncertainty that underpins the need for insurance is now shrinking thanks to better insight to the individual risk. I think someone has rightly pointed out this looks more like the inference what is coming out, or even the summary or inference. Again, we can debate that, but this certainly is not the correct one. And how will you go with the next line? Business is instead moving to, and therefore the business is moving to, then I would have gone ahead with this. Just think over it. The certainty that underpins the need for insurance is now shrinking thanks to better insight into individual risk. What should be the next line? And therefore the business is moving to digital native insurance. Should that not be the next sentence? Why 20 or 25 minutes? I do not understand this. I told you these questions appear only in mains. Okay, Saurav says he is sorry. He thought, I have still, it has not yet appeared. If it appears, you can choose. If you feel it is time consuming, you can choose to leave it. But I don't think it should actually appear in prelims. All the 10 questions that we have here have all appeared either in SBI PO mains or IBPS PO mains. And you have good 40 minutes. You can really think over it. You have only 35 questions in 40 minutes in English. That's like luxury. Please try to understand the contrast which is being portrayed here, and that is why I have eliminated option D and E. I hope that is clear. If you do not get it, it is a problem. If two are nearly same, you have to go with the best. You still have to choose the best. Please try to understand. Okay, let me just go to the next question now. Please try to solve it. I'll go on mute, and please give me your explanation also. all with whoever had DNE, please try to read with DNE. Can you have the word instead in the next line? If you choose, please try to choose, fit it yourself. Please try to choose, you know, confuse between C and D, Pushpendra. Please try to read the line D, and can the word instead be there? If you start the sentence with D, can you have the word instead there? Please try to understand it. Mohit said he got it thoroughly. How to predict contrast? If the words like instead, however, despite, etc. are used, you know what has followed before will be in contrast to what has followed later. So you, it will not be a continuation of idea, but contrast. That is why we eliminated D and E, because that would have been continuation, not the contrast. How D perfectly fits, Umeshwar, please try to read it. Okay, I'll just go back, you know, just excuse me guys, let me try it if I'm getting it wrong somewhere. The uncertainty that underpins the need for insurance is now shrinking thanks to the better insight into individual risk because of technology, right? So business is instead moving to, or therefore the business is moving to digital native insurance. Please try to understand what will come there. Okay, now someone is asking, what is, it's not unionized, you can read it like that, but it's unionized. So something which is unionized is, forming union, ununionized is not forming the union, okay. Please do not read it as unionized, okay. Unmute. Umeshwar says, I am not taking his question. I just took your question. How many times do you want me to tell that D does not fit there? If you have other question, please post. I'll look into it now. Okay, I do not see much confusion in this. I'll just give you the background. I think all those who attended the, I think it was last to last class wherein I discussed about it. What is unionized worker? What is the benefit of union worker? What is collective bargaining? So all those things I have already discussed in brief. So what is happening here is all these guys, the union leaders, they feel if they go for minimum wages for the unionized worker, their clout effectively diminishes, because once a minimum wage is in place, first it is applicable for both unionized and ununionized people, and at the same time those who are also in union, because they now know that the management has no choice but to pay them the minimum wage, these guys do not go and respect their union or pay their dues. So that is the entire story behind this passage. Now what will these guys do? These guys are now asking their management to exempt unionized business from minimum wage. Once that is done, then even the ununionized guys will not get any minimum wage. And now for negotiation, these guys will have more power. That is the crux of this paragraph. Now, by calling for exempting unionized business from minimum wages, unions are creating more incentives for employers to favor unionized worker over non-unionized sort, and therefore even the employers will find it very helpful so that he has all his, you know, employees under the under a union. So that helps them also, so that he will just have to talk to one or two guys and not individually settle each and other cases. At the same time, these guys are not asking for minimum wages, so that part is also settled. And all these guys who are the union leaders will also have their clout, because they have no other choice but to form or to come into the union. Okay, all those who thought it was prelims question, it is not in prelims. Please try to understand. This is the second last topic, even from the point of view of mains. Such exemptions strengthen their power dash. So what we are talking about is increasing their clout and strength by asking for no minimum wages. Employers are now forcing their worker to form union, which strengthen strengthens the cause of the leader, the union guys, and they are also happy, and the employers are also happy. Once employers are obliged to pay the same minimum wage to both unionized and non-unionized laborers, workers often see less reason to pay the dues to join a union. This is what I have already explained. Now, high rate of unionization make minimum wage rule unnecessary, as collaborative wage setting achieves the flexibility goal of low minimum wages and fairness goals of a high one. Again, this is out of context. Workers who have no real alternative to employment in the unregulated shadow of the labor market are even more vulnerable to exploitation and abuse. This is what is the reason, and this should not ideally be the cause for not asking for minimum wage. This is exactly in contrast. The labor ethos of worker solidarity seems hollow if non-unionized workers are underpriced by union worker and left unemployed or scrambling for unauthorized work. Again, look at this line. This is the very reason why they are now asking for asking for exempt, because if they just fight for their right and not for those who are not the part of union, then their ethos, what are they lying on? They want to bring equality to all the worker. They want to ensure they are not exploited. So can they hold it true only for the worker who will join union and not think about it for the people who do not join their union? The entire their ethic will seem hollow, right? Even this goes in contrast with the passage. This is useful because all the effort union throw at raising the minimum wage law for better pay have an awkward habit of undermining their union clout. This is what the entire passage is talking about. Union have been demanding democratic values in work culture, but on contrary, they have been practicing dictatorial ways. This is again out of context here. I hope this is clear. Paint the union in negative light. No, they are talking about, okay, Gautam Jha, okay, let us try to read A. High rate of unionization make minimum wage rule unnecessary, as collaborative wage setting achieves flexible goal of low minimum wage and fairness goal of a high one. This does not happen, right? This is in itself contradictory. High rate of unionization makes minimum wage rule unnecessary. Who told that? If you have high rate of unionization, then it becomes more necessary, right? They have more bargaining power. I think this is in contrast to the entire concept itself. High rates of unionization makes minimum rule not unnecessary. They are trying to go against this common notion that unionization, they are forming union and they are calling for they want no minimum wages. This is contrary to common understanding what it is talking about here. High rate of unionization makes it necessary for minimum rule necessary. That is called the collective bargaining. What happens is these union leaders will go and collectively bargain. Ayush says he is not getting my point. I will again repeat what is happening here. This is in contrast to our common understanding. High rate of, okay, by calling for exempting unionized business from minimum wage, unions are creating more incentive for employers to favor unionized worker over non-unionized sort. Such exemption strengthen their power. Who are we talking about? We are talking about their power here is the unionized, the leaders that we are talking about, the leaders of this union we are talking about. High rate of unionization make minimum wage rule unnecessary. This is completely false. This line is completely false. The high rate of unionization is what ultimately drives minimum wage rule. The collective bargaining happens only because one or two guys represent 500 people. They go and say, no boss, we cannot work on $6 per hour. You will have to give us $10 or $15 per hour. As collaborative wage setting achieve the flexibility goal of low minimum wage, and the fairness goal of a high one. No, this is, you know, for making minimum wage rule unnecessarily, this is in itself, you know, totally wrong. Okay, someone says, isko Hindi mein samjhao. So, let me just spend some time even in Hindi. Agar shayad meri angrezi itni achhi nahi hai, main aapko Hindi mein samjhane ki koshish karta hoon isko. Is wale ko aap samajhne ki koshish kijiye, hota kya hai. जब आप किसी फैक्ट्री में जाते हैं तो वहाँ दो तरह के आपको जनरली वर्कर मिलेंगे, जो एक यूनियन का पार्ट हो और एक यूनियन का पार्ट नहीं हो. यूनियन का जो पार्ट होते हैं वो लोग क्या करते हैं, कलेक्टिव बार्गेनिंग एक टेक्निकल लॉ का टर्म है, जिसमें आप जाते हैं और अपने एम्प्लॉयर से बार्गेन करते हैं कि सर मुझे इतने पैसे मिनिमम मिलने चाहिए. तो उसमें जो आपके जो लीडर लोग होते हैं ना, वो जाते हैं और आपके बिहाव पर ये करते हैं. इस पैसेज में क्या बोलता है कि अगर ऐसा करते हैं जब ये लीडर, तो उसके बाद धीरे धीरे उनका क्लाउड खत्म हो जाता है. एक बार जैसे ही मिनिमम वेज सेट हो गया तो वो एक रूल बन जाता है, वो यूनियनाइज वर्कर हो या नॉन यूनियन के वर्कर हो, दोनों के लिए वो अप्लीकेबल हो जाता है. इससे क्या होता है कि आपके जो यूनियन लीडर हैं उनका जो पूरा वो क्या होता है ना, वो एक अलग ऑरा में रहते हैं, वो उनको वो रईसी अच्छी लगती है, जिसमें लोग उनके आगे पीछे जा करके कहें कि सर देखो चलो हम मेरा ये बढ़वा दो, आप ही हमारे तारनहार हो, और ये वाला फीलिंग जो उनका होता है ना, उनका क्लाउट उनका स्ट्रेंथ वो पूरा का पूरा हट जाता है. सबसे पहले तो जो नॉन यूनियन है उनको तो बिना यूनियन में गए वो मिनिमम वेज मिल गया, और दूसरा वाला जो यूनियन के पार्ट थे अब वो उनको क्या वैल्यू करेंगे. एक बार जब मेरे को साल का मेरे को मिनिमम वेज एक बार स्टैब्लिश हो गया तो मेरे को अब उनके पास जाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. फर्स्ट लाइन जो बोलता है वो बोलता है कि हाई रेट ऑफ यूनियनाइजेशन मेक मिनिमम वेज रूल अननेसेसरी, वो अपने आप में एक गलत बात है. जब हाई अगर यूनियनाइजेशन हो तभी वो आपको जाकर के बात करते हैं मिनिमम कलेक्टिव बार्गेनिंग के तहत, वो एक जाकर के मिनिमम वेज की बात करते हैं. यहाँ पर जो पैराग्राफ बात कर रहा है ये आप देखिए कि ये एम्प्लॉयर के पर्सपेक्टिव से बात नहीं कर रहा. अगर आपको ये इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं भी पता, ये बात कर रहा है हमारे यूनियन वर्कर जो उनके जो लीडर हैं यूनियन के हेड हैं उनकी बात कर रहा है, और उन पर ये कैसे इफेक्ट कर रहा है. दीज गाइज आर नॉट एबल टू गेट दैट ड्यू रेस्पेक्ट, उनका क्लाउड कमजोर हो रहा है. और जब अगर वो मिनिमम वेज की बात हटा देंगे तब लोग इनके पास आएंगे, मजबूर हो जाएंगे और इनसे बोलेंगे सर आप चलो मेरे लिए कुछ करो, आप एक मिनिमम वेज ना रख करके लेकिन एक मिनिमम आप इस साल के लिए कुछ हमारे लिए इंसेंटिव करा दो या कुछ करा दो. और एम्प्लॉयर्स के लिए कैसे बेनिफिशियल है कि अब उसको अगर जो अगर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन कि अलग अलग स्किल के जो वर्कर हैं डिपेंडिंग अपॉन डिमांड सप्लाई अब मैं रखूंगा. अब पहले मेरे को कोई भी था तो उसको $10 देना ही पड़ रहा था या 150 रुपये या जो भी 400 रुपये नरेगा के तहत है देना पड़ रहा है. लेकिन अगर इस तरह के मिनिमम वेज का अगर कोई क्लॉज नहीं है और अगर मेरे पास 200 वर्कर खड़े हैं और मेरे को बस 10 ही वर्कर चाहिए तो मैं उनसे 200 रुपये में भी काम कराऊंगा ना, ये एक्सप्लॉयटेशन है. लेकिन ये हो रहा है और यही होता हर जगह की फैक्ट्री में, सारे कैपिटलिस्ट इकोनॉमी में, और फॉर दैट मैटर जो इविल ऑफ कैपिटलिज्म है यही है ना, एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग रिसोर्सेज अगर उसकी ये है. और सेम चीज़ लेबर भी करते हैं, जहाँ पर लेबर कम होते हैं वहाँ पर वो जा करके ज़्यादा दाम मांगते हैं. यही पूरा का पूरा है इस पूरे कॉन्टेक्स्ट इस पैसेज का. अब तो मैंने पूरा हिंदी में समझा दिया, आई होप आपको समझ में आ रहा होगा. I hope this is clear. Can I move to the next question now? And now, you know, even after me explaining this in Hindi, after, you know, explaining all the words used here, you are finding it difficult. That is why we emphasize so much on the importance of understanding the language, you know, giving some due respect to English, because now we cannot do without it. So, for all those who did not understand Hindi for last 10 minutes, I was talking in English. I hope I could make you understand. Okay, let me just move to the next question, try to answer this. I think I am satisfied. Ayush finally said he got it. So I am really happy. Guys, please try to understand, these are really difficult questions. It will come with a lot of practice. Just talking freely in English is not the point. There are still many questions to come. It took me 10 times to understand. Trust me, I'm not exaggerating. I'll show you that passage. It took me 10 times for me to understand. I have good reading habit. I'm not, boasting. I know my English. If I have to rate myself somewhere, I'm mediocre in English. I have, lot of room for improvement. I constantly try to understand. I read a lot. I try to improve myself on a constant basis. But you have to give it to them. These questions are really difficult ones. You have to, respect this question and take encouragement, not get disappointed. Please try to understand, it will be difficult for everyone. So try to understand, get hang of language, read more and more, practice more and more. That is the message here. Please try to understand that. Don't get disappointed at all. Okay, someone asked, what does eviscerate means? Eviscerate, first I'll explain in Hindi, then I'll tell in Hindi. वो मरे हुए जानवर होते हैं ना, उनको काट करके उसके अंदर से वो सारा उसका जो निकाल लेते हैं एंड देन उसके बाद उसको स्टफ करके ये करते हैं, दैट इज evisceration. In English, if you have a dead animal, you cut it and you take out all its gut, etc. and then stuff it. So taking out the real part from inside, that is eviscerate here means. Okay, I think P4K is saying, why we are solving this kind of question in 2017, what do you expect me to do now? I do not understand. Please also, when you give some suggestion, also give what you think also, it will help everyone. Now, I do not see much problem in this question. I think this was fairly, easy. And let me just explain to you what this passage was about. And I get a lot of correct answer, which is E, which is saying it is continuation to what the prior skill was, and it is in continuation with what follows about what the potential employers are going to look for in their employees. It's E, it's E, D and E confused, E, E, maximum is saying, E and D, some confusion. Okay, let's see, let's quickly read it. The premise that the choice of major is basically the subject in which you are, pursuing your final graduation or post-graduation, amounts to choosing a career path, rests on the faulty notion that the major is important for its content and that the acquisition of that content is valuable to employers. So, what are they saying here? Ki if you think that just because you are major in, say, marketing, so that is good enough a reason to get your marketing job, or if you are a chemistry honors, you will get a job in something related to chemistry, is not what is happening today, because the world is changing so fast, but the information is fairly easy to acquire, and what is required in 2015 will be obsolete by 2020. So what they want to put emphasis on, the knowledge itself is not the key. The knowledge of the subject matter per se is not important. What is more important is your ability to learn. Why they are saying there is less importance? Say for example, when we took a course in 2008, there was digital marketing was just getting when we did our MBA in 2009 to 2011, when I went to Lucknow, digital marketing was at this nascent stage. But at this point in time, we hardly had one or two courses. But today I think the entire marketing course should ideally be revolving around digital marketing. That is what is happening. So what was relevant in 2015 is not relevant in 2020, and you know, just happened. You know, I can see myself as an example. So what was relevant at my time is not at all relevant today. So that is what employers very well know. They are, you know, far-sighted. What employers want are basic but difficult to acquire skill. Knowledge is not that difficult. They can give you that 3 months training, 4 month training, 6 month training, and they can just drill down that information in your head. What is more difficult for these employers are your basic abilities, you know, more difficult skills, which is, you know, your communication skills, you know, how you behave, how good you are with people, your reasoning skills, your analytical skills. These are not something which are developed in a month or two. This is something that you gather over years. That is what they want to emphasize here. They care about a potential employee's ability, writing, researching, quantitative and analytical skill. A vocational approach to education eviscerates precisely the qualities that are most valued about it: intellectual curiosity, creativity and critical thinking. So very interesting, like the vocational approach. What is the vocational approach? The approach when you go for any education, all you are thinking about ki bhaiya isse kya job milega, what job will I get out of this, that eviscerates, wo nikal leta hai, that, you know, just cuts the education, takes out all those gut and all the good things inside the education, which is the intellectual curiosity that education is supposed to develop, the creativity, the critical thinking aspect of it. It all, you know, takes out if you just go with that mentality of only learning the subject, only the content matter, and not getting your basics right. It just defeats the entire purpose of education, and that is what these guys, your employers, are actually looking for. They are not looking for what you have learned. They want to see, have you developed those soft skills? Are you intellectually curious? Are you, you know, thinking creatively? So just now in these contexts, read, I think there should not be any problem marking E. When they ask student about their major, it is usually not because they want to assess the applicant's mastery of the content. Clearly mentioned here, you know, they are, you know, not at all bothered about what is acquired in 2015 will be obsolete. So they do not want to see your mastery over the content, but rather because they want to know if the student can talk about what they have learned. You know, how convincingly can you put your communication skill, how you have thought over it. That is what they want to see, not just the content. Okay, I hope you are able to understand. Let's see why people are having confusion with D. Ideas such as education is necessary to be successful in corporate life are unacceptable because education isn't much relevant in today's society. This is far-fetched, yeah. How can you say education isn't much relevant in today's society? They have not mentioned it at all. The vocational approach to education is what they are criticizing, not the education itself. Education is actually meant to do all these things. They are supposed to increase your intellectual curiosity. They want to, you know, improve your curiosity, your creativity, your critical thinking. So education is not something they are, you know, doubting, or they are not questioning education. They are questioning the vocational approach, that mindset that now I am going and taking this major only to get so and so job. That is my problem. Ankit is asking, these passages are not shy, these have already appeared. So my suggestion would be to start reading as much as you can, read from various sources and try to improve your vocabulary, develop a good reading habit. Ankit, there is no other way out. You know, you can, I think, if there is some gutti, if you guys know, please let me also know. I at least do not know of any shortcut here. I cannot find at least till today, I have not been able to find digit some method for these kind of questions. Okay, this is very simple. You know, this was a setter here. I think all of you should get it in 10-15 seconds. You know, whatever 30 seconds you take to read the question, and then in 10 seconds, you should get this right. I did not discuss option A, B, C because they were not even close. I could understand some problem in D and E. I discussed that. First, I think he was talking about professor and what kind of stress he will have by taking majority of the courses. Okay. Read from various sources. Gautam is asking, suggest a source. Personally, when I started reading, I read only the fiction books. Then I joined Olam. There I saw, I met a guy who I was really amazed with his knowledge, I'll tell you honestly. And then I thought, you know, even I have been reading for past 2-3 years, then what have I actually read? This guy just read all non-fiction. I know it is very difficult to read, it was really cumbersome, but he had vast knowledge, perspective about, you know, and having knowledge about practically, I think, everything, you know, whatever conversation we got in, he had perspective. He impressed me so much that I just stopped reading all fiction books from that day. I read only non-fiction book and, you know, spend time on Wikipedia. If you ask me the best source to start read, get into reading habit, devote 1 or 2 hours daily with, you know, your Wikipedia pages. You start with, say, philosophy or psychology, read. Just keep doing the right click. You will read at least, you know, if you have not developed a good reading habit, you will, even when first 5-6 paragraph, you will get at least 10-20 new pages will be open for you to read. So, you know, I used to start with philosophy and end in some quantum mechanics or, you know, somewhere else. And that is how I slowly developed, and I am still far from, you know, saying that I today have a very good understanding of all the subject. I still strive for it. I still read at least 20-30 pages every day, random reading about various topics that I do not know about. So please inculcate that habit. It will be slow, but it will be very useful. Very good. Silika Gupta, Siva Sai, all those who are saying B and giving correct reason also. I am really happy. Finally, you know, why will you, you know, go for A? You know, this is absolute sitter. You cannot get this wrong. Please. Yes, Ankita, right. Kundan, Ankit Tiwari, I think all of you are getting it right. Very good. Yes, yes, all those who are giving option B are also giving me correct reason. That makes me, you know, happier. Okay, what happens to our brain as we age is of crucial importance, not just to science, but to public policy. Okay, now I can understand you do not know what is written here. However, this demography, what is this, just throws away everything. This demographic time bomb, which is, you know, just mentioned here. Here, what should come? Demographic. What is demographic? Age distribution, all the information related to how the age distribution is, taken place. So, it was a sitter. However, this demographic time bomb would be much less threatening if the elderly were looked upon as intelligent contributors to society rather than as dependents in long-term decline. It is time we rethink what we mean by aging mind before our false assumption result in decisions and policies that marginalize the old or waste precious public resources to remediate problem that do not exist. Okay, so absolutely not necessary. None of these lines were necessary. So only option which talks about, you know, demographics by 2030, for example, 72 million people over 65, double the figure in 20, will have average life expectancy, will likely to have aged above 20 years. This was absolute sitter. Please try to understand. This was one mark thrown at you. So, you know, worst possible scenario also, you could have scored only 0 in this, because out of 5, if you got the other 4 wrong, this was a sitter. You know, worst possible case, you would have scored a 0, not negative here. All the reason to attempt this question. I hope there is no confusion with anyone, you know, this throws away. However, that this demographic time bomb has to refer to the demography which has been talked about here. Absolutely no confusion at all. Nimisha is still adamant on one. Okay, let us read. What happens to our brain as we age is of crucial importance, not just to science but to public policy. The idea that we get dumber as we grow old is just a myth. According to brain research, that will encourage anyone old enough to know better. However, this demographic time bomb, how I can justify this? Now, even if I justify this, let us move forward. They are seen as, you know, long-term society, contributors to the long-term society. According to brain research, that will encourage anyone. Is this not far-fetched? You know, where is this, you know, getting dumber, getting even talked about? Non-contributor is talked about, but getting dumber, where is this talked about? Okay, let me just go to the next question. It's really this one. Let's see. First, let me see how many of you get this right. Okay, now Nimisha says she is happy with the explanation. Okay, good. Vaishali says she is now, you know, word power made easier, really helped her improve vocabulary. That is what it was meant to. She is also using mnemonics now. She is able to understand the tone of passage now. That is very good. Do not regress from here, only progress. Keep building your vocabulary. Vocabulary building is a lifelong process. Please try to understand, I have not made this question, they have actually appeared in your examination that you are going to take now. Wow, Madhu says she missed the sitter. Out of the four, I think previous, she got only one incorrect, which was the sitter. Okay. Sitter is the easy one. I think it's informal. It's a more colloquial usage in British English basically. When you drop a catch, मतलब अगर आप क्रिकेट देखते हो निमिषा, अगर हाथ में आया हुआ कैच आप ड्रॉप कर देते हो तो वो बोलता है यू ड्रॉप द सिटर. उसको उस तरह से अगर फुटबॉल के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में इफ़ यू वॉच फुटबॉल, आप पेनल्टी किक लूज मिस कर देते हो या एकदम गोल पोस्ट के सामने जा करके free kick up, you miss, that is sitter. That is in generally two contexts where it is used. Soma Vishwas, she says she got all incorrect. Please do not worry about it, but definitely speaks about your reading habits and vocabulary, Soma. That is a reason of worry. Don't get perturbed. You still have a month to go for prelims, almost, okay, now 23 days now, and then another month for your mains. These are questions in mains. Let's hope that it'll come only in mains. Okay. Satyend Agra Hari says, am I late? You are very late. We are almost concluding now. Okay. I think all of you are getting it right. Very good. In fact, I will have, I think, problem explaining why some of the answer choices are incorrect. So let me just start. Let me try to explain. The expenditure of time, money and sparse is less. Few judicial and prosecutorial resources is often justified by claims of a powerful deterrent message. What is a deterrent message? Which strongly forbids. Jusse ekdam ruk jaye. Ekdam, matlab, wo hota na, vaidhanik chetavni shayad usko वो बोलते हैं ना, मतलब जिससे शायद आई एम नॉट श्योर अबाउट द हिंदी वर्ड, बट डिट्रेंट इज समथिंग विच फॉरबिड्स यू टू डू इट, एम्बॉडीड इन इट्स इन द अल्टीमेट पनिशमेंट द डेथ पेनल्टी. ओके डैश इन 2010 एवरेज टाइम बिटवीन सेंटेंसिंग एंड एग्जीक्यूशन इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट एवरेज 15 ईयर्स. ओके गुड, सिर्फ इंडिया में नहीं यूएस में भी ऐसा होता है. चलिए, अ मच मोर इफेक्टिव डेटरेंट वुड बी अ सेंटेंस ऑफ लाइफ इम्प्रिजनमेंट इम्पोज क्लोज इन टाइम टू द क्राइम. ओके सो वट इज इज टॉकिंग अबाउट इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टोन इज वेरी क्लियर. दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, दे आर डिस्कसिंग डेथ पेनल्टी एंड दे आर टॉकिंग इट इज नॉट अ ग्रेट आइडिया टू हैव डेथ पेनल्टी, अ बेटर ऑप्शन इज द लाइफ इम्प्रिजनमेंट. आई होप दिस इज वेरी क्लियर. ओके नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू फिट इट. ओके एंड सी, अ सिंगल फेडरल डेथ पेनल्टी केस इन फिलाडेल्फिया वॉज फाउंड टू कॉस्ट अपवर्ड ऑफ 10 मिलियन, 8 times higher than the cost of trying death eligible cases where prosecutors seek only life imprisonment. This, you know, looks good because they are talking about time and money. This talks about money. Next line talks about time. Okay, I am not having any problem. The ethics of the issue aside, nowhere talked about. This is clearly out of context. If I would have started my line or, you know, some mention here, or, you know, I would have started the paragraph as death penalty, as we know, in spite of all the troubles and the trauma that it can cause to patient and the culprit or the accused and his family, it also has a lot of ethical issues attached to it. Then the next line, the ethical issues of, you know, ethics of the issues aside, would have been right. Clearly, ethics are not at all discussed. This is out of question. Let us eliminate this. Apart from delaying justice, the death penalty divert resources that could be used to help victim family heal. Not, no mention at all. It is just talking about death penalty and how it is, you know, costly an option compared to life imprisonment. We are not at all talking about the victim's family. But studies repeatedly suggest there is no meaningful deterrent effect associated with the death penalty, and further, any deterrent impact is no doubt greatly diluted by the amount of time that inevitably passed between the time of conduct and punishment. Now it is clearly connected with the, you know, it first of all takes a dig at the very basic assumption that it acts as deterrent message. It first tries to nullify with the help of studies, and then it talks about a lot of time it takes, and, you know, then next sentence gives you the 15-year example. Clearly fits. So A and D so far is, you know, fitting it. While some victims and their families supported and some opposed, why are we even talking about victim families here? We are talking about only in the general context of how these two. Now read and choose between A and D. You cannot have any other option, right? Now just read this. Can this line alone suffice this conclusion? A deterrent would be life imprisonment. You see, what is it talking about? It is first talking about the life imprisonment is justified by deterrent message. Then it talks about the time and money if I choose A. But is it talking about a much more effective deterrent would be life imprisonment? Does this, you know, give me enough hint? If I do not have D, I will go with A. But now if I have the option of D, which clearly talks about, first it nullifies the assumption of the deterrent message, but repeatedly it shows the contrast. Whatever was assumed here, there is no meaningful deterrent effect associated with the death penalty. Any further impact would no doubt greatly dilute the amount of time that inevitably pass from the time between the time of conduct and punishment. This is what, you know, is being elaborated here. The average time between the sentencing and, you know, those 15 years which pass in between the sentencing and execution is what they want to eliminate. So between A and D, if you have to choose, please try to think. I cannot give you any better explanation to this, that I will go for choice D. Between A and D, D looks good. I think most of you are convinced. Other options are out of question. Why are we talking about ethics? The paragraph does not talk about ethics. It's not talking about the victim family. So all three options are already eliminated. So when you try to zero down, please first try to remove the redundant one. That is the first advice. Okay? What is deterrent? I explained, deterrent is something which forbids, which stops you from doing something. A deterrent message, you know, if the warden of a hostel says he will throw you out even at, you know, midnight if he sees a bottle of wine or, you know, any alcoholic beverage in your room. That's a deterrent message. You will be thrown out of the hostel. Any message which, you know, forbids you to do something. Not really, Vishal. If you say time is not just of the essence here, between these two, please try to see. I can understand people choosing A as option, but please try to read this entire paragraph and try to choose between A and D. D becomes a better choice. Now, Poorna, I think, also has the same problem, except the sitter, others were correct. Very good. Madhu also got 4 correct, 1 wrong, which was a sitter. Okay, these were the correct answers. This is IBPS main. They have taken it to a different level, trust me. Just read the passage and you will understand the exam, and then all those who complain about us focusing or trying to speak with our limited English also, if you have problem, just read these 5 questions and you will understand why we are stressing so much on English. Abhilash, I just explained. A also talks about the time and money aspect. It gives the example of money and then the next one time, but it does it talk about, you know, between A and D. D first negates the deterrent message and then it talks about an alternative also, and hence I chose D to, you know, be a better choice. Please read these 2 sentences and then you will understand why D should be chosen over A. Again, it's a matter of A, I am not saying is incorrect, but if I have been given a choice between A and D, I will choose D. Just Wish For You says that it is tough. It is tough. Undoubtedly, it is tough. Without any doubt, these are tough questions, but these appear in your examination now, and I have not even posting the CAT question. These are all IBPS and SBI questions which I have posted for you. Recondite, someone asks, it's abstruse, which is difficult to understand. Recondite matters are difficult to comprehend. As you know, these are recondite passages or the paragraphs that you are getting. And I'm trying to expound. What is expound? Present in detail. So, as the time traveler was expounding a recondite matter to us, precisely what I'm trying to do here. Gautam says he got 14 in PO mains. What was the cutoff of that paper? I think it was much below 14, I guess. It was very less. Please check it. I think you can Google it. Soma says it, I got 8.75. I think there will be a lot of people who might have missed because, you know, they did not take English seriously. Just Vishwa says bank exam are tougher than even CAT now. I'll not say tougher, they are, you know, almost at par now. Let's wait for, you know, SBI paper and we'll get to know. What I have seen so far, SBI sets a new standard every time and IBPS tries to surpass it, and then SBI again sets a new standard. So I think they are not even competing with CAT anymore. I think, you know, it's just matter of time that, you know, people preparing for CAT will say, chalo bank wala question practice kar lete hain, CAT aram se ho jayega. Gautam says 3.75 was the cutoff. Okay. Ideal Mark Gautam Jha, there is, you know, nothing. I think I have seen few scorecards of around 17, 18, 20, 22. I think anything above 20 was good, looking at the difficulty of the paper. I think you can score. In 40 minutes, 35 question, 20 plus is not a bad score. Okay, all those, you know, trying to debate how much marks should be there, if that was your point, then please watch the orientation video. You will understand all these things are discussed in detail there, and you have to score somewhere. You have seen, you know, many of your friends have missed it in spite of clearing all the individual cutoffs. Also, I think some of them have missed it because they did not excel in one or two of the sections. Kishore says, yes, you can. You have to put in a lot of hard work. You have to put in a lot of hard work. Okay, a lot of you are getting lock kar do B. Okay, C, B and C. Okay, I think this was pretty difficult. If you ask me, it was pretty difficult. Absolutely no idea. You can eliminate few options. Let us try to do it together. The time traveler, for so it will be convenient to speak of him, was expounding a recondite matter to us. Expounding is explaining in great detail. Recondite, I just told, abstruse or difficult matter. His grey eyes shone and twinkled. Aankhye uski chamak rahi thi, timtima rahi thi. As his usually pale face was flushed and animated. Flushed face kya hota hai? When you are talking with lot of passion, you will have, you know, blood in your face. Chehre pe wo khoon aa jana bolte na. Your face becomes red because you are so passionately explaining this. There is a rush of blood on your face and animated with all those expression about talking about your passion for the subject. The fire burned brightly and the soft radiance of the incandescent light. Incandescent light, what are those incandescent light? Which emits light because of the heat. Okay, jo fireplace mein, if you have those log of wood, wo jal jane ke baad, that's incandescent light. In the lilies of silver, lilies, I think you know, are the type of flowers which have perfume, caught the bubbles that flashed and passed in our glasses. Okay, our chairs, being his patents, embraced and caressed us rather than submitted to be sat upon, and there was that luxurious after dinner atmosphere when thoughts roam gracefully free of the trammels of precision. Look at these words, you know, amazing, you know. Okay, first of all, this one, embraced, I am quite sure, you know, hugging each other, or, you know, holding each other gently, that is embraced. Caressed is, you know, stroking gently. A mother will caress her kid, stroking gently. Us, rather than submitted to be sat upon. So, you know, this is how they are explaining. Even the chairs have life, some kind of life. They are also involved in the discussion. They are also making this discussion lively. That is what is, you know, meant by trying to bring life to this chair. Please try to understand, this is not what is actually happening. This is how author wants to create that aura of liveliness. And there was that luxurious after dinner atmosphere where thoughts roam gracefully free of trammels of precision. What is trammels? Restrictions. Trammels are the restriction and precision is exactness. So we know already, what is this guy going to talk about? He's going to talk about things which are not to our conventional wisdom. He is going to let his thought go loose. He will talk about things which will be difficult for us to accept if we put them into current notion of logic and science. That is what, you know, this after dinner luxurious atmosphere when thoughts roam gracefully free of trammels of precision. Trammels of precision, wonderful usage of word. Restriction of, you know, being exact or logical. And slowly and steadily the atmosphere grew stale and lost all will an author do this? You know, all these 4-5 lines he has built up, you know, trying to make something very significant, something very, you'll never have these anti-climax kind of sentences. If you get it, please remove it. Even if you are, you know, pessimistic in your thought and thinking this could be a logical ending, please remove it. Even if it in actual paragraph, this was the, you know, anti-climax, that I and you as a student cannot do it, okay? Now, and he put it to us in this way, marking the points with a lean forefinger. वो उंगली दिखा करके ना ऐसे समझा रहा है, यू नो, ही इज जस्ट पॉइंटिंग हिज लीन फोर फिंगर पॉइंटिंग एट यू एंड ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग एज वी सैट लेजिली एडमायर्ड हिज अर्नेस्टनेस ओवर द न्यू पैराडॉक्स एज वी थॉट एंड हिज फेकंडिटी विच इज फेकंडिटी इज प्रोडक्टिवनेस इफ आई एम फेकंड इफ आई माई आइडियाज आर फेकंड आई एम फर्टाइल इन माई आइडियाज आई कम अप विथ न्यू आइडियाज दैट इज फेकंडिटी इज वॉट इज बींग टॉक्ड अबाउट. This is what, you know, is the hint here. There was luxurious after dinner atmosphere when thoughts roam gracefully free of trammels of precision with the earnest over the new paradox. Paradox is something, you know, which is contrary to your logical sense. When you listen to it, it is, you will feel that it is not satisfying your conventional wisdom. And his fecundity, I just told you, his productive ideas. So I think this is the hint here, if you ask me, if you knew all this word, thoughts roam gracefully, feeling that free of the trammels of precision, he is talking about those paradoxes and, you know, he is coming up with new ideas is what, and he is talking all about, you know, this flushed and animated face is what is, you know, giving you the hint of marking the earnestness, you know, over his new paradox is what is giving you the hint. Okay, if you did not get this, let's see. Still, we sat like toddlers do in nursery, eagerly anticipating the show the time traveler would put on us. It was clearly talking about, you know, there is not some kind of show that he is really going to put about. And why we sat like toddlers, I think if you got confused with the word caress, you know, which generally that is the loving stoking which the chair is giving to you, and you are sitting like toddlers and this time traveler will now unveil something new to you. We said benumbed is, you know, mesmerized, your mind not working, but I think this is not benumbed. In fact, you are luxurious after dinner atmosphere. You are sitting, you know, with very light head. So this we said benumbed by the proceeding, I don't think it's, you know, going with the what we have read here. There was a luxurious after dinner atmosphere. Why will you get benumbed in, you know, luxurious after dinner atmosphere where thoughts are free to roam? You know, you will also think, right? Why you will not get benumbed by the proceeding? For radiance, you know, what is being talked about here is something very new is happening. This time traveler is animated. He is very excited about it. And the atmosphere is also supporting it because he is also coming up with new ideas, and you are also ready to listen to it. Your and his both minds are free to roam free and not be restricted upon the conventional wisdom. I caught Philby's eyes, nowhere mentioned. So now I totally understand people confuse between A and C. You know, there are enough hint at this also. But now, after what I have explained to you, please choose between A and C. It is between B and C now. Just see, does this look like, you know, is it not stretching it a bit too much? We sat like toddlers do in nursery, eagerly waiting, anticipating the show the time traveler would put on us. Means, you know, and are we talking about any specific show that we do not know? We already know he is very excited about expounding a recondite matter, which is more likely to go with the paradox, which is something new which we do not know about, or even if we know, we are not likely to agree with. I hope all my last 5-10 minutes of explaining, you know, I have been able to explain this to you. okay, you cannot, unfortunately, even, you know, I do not have problem if you do not want to listen to all these, I'm perfectly fine, but these questions will appear in your main examination, so I'm just giving you a sense of it. Ab Hindi mein bhi samajhna hai, okay, ek bar main samjhane ki koshish karta hu. Isme jo hai, do log baithe hue hain, ek time traveler unko bata rahe hain, wo kya kar raha hai, bahut hi difficult subject ko bahut hi detail mein samjhane ki koshish kar raha hai. He is really passionate about it. Uske chehre par wo pura passion dikh raha hai. Uska chehra lal ho chuka hai. He is animated. Aur wahan ka wo ek post dinner environment ke bare mein bataya ja raha hai, jahan par log kafi relaxed hain and they are ready to accept new ideas. Ye hai background. Ab isme agar aap jab aapke options padhte ho to do options mein log confused hain between B and C. B mein aapko ye jo hai wo bol raha hai कि अब ये जो है आपका जो टाइम ट्रैवलर जिसको ये दो लोग बता रहे हैं वो इसको बहुत अर्नेस्टली एक्सप्लेन कर रहा है, एक पैराडॉक्स समझाने की कोशिश कर रहा है और उसको समझाने की कोशिश कर रहा है. और दूसरा वाला जो है वहाँ पर क्या है, वो आपको बोल रहा है आप बच्चों की तरह उसको देख रहे हैं और आप समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. इसका हिंट जो हमें मिल रहा था वो इस लाइन से मिल रहा था, एंड देयर वॉज दैट लग्जूरियस आफ्टर डिनर एटमोसफेयर व्हेन थॉट्स रोम ग्रेसफुली फ्री ऑफ द ट्रैमल्स ऑफ प्रिसिजन. यहाँ पर ये बोलना चाह रहा है कि डिनर करने के बाद आप रिलैक्स्ड हैं, आप वहाँ पर जब जाकर के बैठते हैं उसके सामने तो आपका माइंड भी फ्री है, आप अपने कन्वेंशनल नोशन और नॉलेज से यू आर नॉट बाउंड बाई दैट, आप अपने थॉट को फ्रीली छोड़ते हैं एंड दैट इज़ वाई यू आर रेडी टू एक्सेप्ट न्यू थॉट्स. और वो जो बंदा जो एक काफ़ी डिफिकल्ट आपको कुछ समझाने की कोशिश कर रहा है वो आपको आप भी समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हो. ओके, यस, इट इज़ अ ब्यूटिफुली क्राफ्टेड पैसेज, प्लीज ट्राई टू रीड इट, ट्राई टू गूगल इट, यू विल गेट इट, ट्राई टू रीड द एंटायर पैसेज. ओके, यस, बी एंड सी वेर कन्फ्यूजिंग, आई विल अग्री विथ. Now, after having explained this, please make a choice. Let's quickly go to this. This is the paragraph I was talking about. Trust me, it'll take you at least 5 times to understand. At least 5 times. If someone can understand in, you know, earlier than that, and please read this. You know, take some time out. Give it at least a try. This I have, you know, just given you. This is where it is picked from. This is Immanuel Kant, famous German philosopher. This is where it's talked about. It's a long passage. Try to read it. They have just taken a part of it and they expect us to fill this. So just try to attempt it. Let's see. Okay, someone asked the answer for last question. I think yes, I will go with B. Between B and C, I convinced myself with B. And I gave you my logic for it. Try to read this. Okay, I'll try to explain, you know, even my understanding is limited here, it's high level philosophy. let us try to understand the definition of metaphysics. Metaphysics is basically physics which talks about, it's a different level. It's not, don't at all get it, you know, confused with physics or mathematics. It talks about the, it starts questioning the very basics, the reason, the existence, the logic. That is metaphysics, a purely speculative science which occupies a completely isolated position and is entirely independent of the teaching of experience. Iska vastavikta se koi lena dena nahi. That is metaphysics basically. You know, if I have to put it simply. Ab iske upar aapko question diya hua hai, to samajhne ki koshish to karni padegi. Theek hai? Either you accept ki panch question to mere ko chhodne hi hai, baki teesi karunga. Now, it deals with mere conception, not like mathematics, with conceptions applied to intuition and in it. Aap ye dekhiye, this part is also interesting. Not like mathematics, with conception applied intuition to it. Ye part mathematics ke bare mein baat kar raha hai, iske bare mein baat nahi kar raha. Aadhe log jo answer kar rahe the A, to unko to ye line hi nahi samajh mein aaya iska matlab. Theek hai? This was the first problem. It deals with mere conception. It is just talking about idea in its pure form. It is questioning what is reason. वो दूर में घुस गए अभी ना हम, आप अगर आप रीजन, ये होता है नहीं, सबसे पहले वो रीजन को क्वेश्चन कर रहा है, मतलब अध्यात्म पर सवाल उठाना, दैट इज मेटाफिजिक्स. मतलब शुरुआत को ही इट क्वेश्चन दी ऑल दी थिंग्स दैट वी नो, द बेसिक दैट वी टेक फॉर ग्रांटेड, क्वेश्चनिंग देम इज मेटाफिजिक्स. ओके, नाउ इन इट द रीजन इज द प्यूपल ऑफ इटसेल्फ अलोन. मतलब इन दिस रीजन अपने आप का ही एक पीपल है. अब नाउ व्हाट डू द ऑथर वांट टू, और यू नो इमैनुअल कांट वांट टू एक्सप्लेन वेदर ओनली रीजन कैन एक्सप्लेन इट और इवन रीजन इज नॉट रियली रिक्वायर्ड हियर. इवन यू नो आई हैव प्रॉब्लम अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट ऑल्सो. इट इज द ओल्डेस्ट ऑफ द साइंसेज. नाउ लुक एट दिस, द वेगनेस ऑफ पैराग्राफ, द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ द पैराग्राफ एंड द सब्जेक्ट मैटर, एंड देन यू आर गिवन दीज 4-5 चॉइसेस. And it would struggle to survive without the architecture of mathematical support that it draws strength from. Clearly, I can cut this. I am very happy because it says that it has got nothing to do with mathematics and reason. Please try to understand that. I can safely eliminate one option. Metaphysics does nothing what mathematics does. Please try to understand it. Okay, next. Yet it continued to baffle mankind because of its abstraction. Now it is, you know, it is the oldest. Again, I can eliminate it. Clearly, we know it is, you know, the oldest, and it is, you know, and yet it continues that, you know, because it is oldest, yet it continues. Okay, now I, you know, in one thought, I will like to eliminate it because its oldness cannot dictate whether it will, you know, baffle mankind today or not. But if I read it from different perspective, that even though it is oldest, people should have already made sense of it, still people have not made sense of it, then this will start making sense to me. Okay, I'm just giving you everything honestly, very honestly, whatever comes to my mind, I'm just telling it to you. You take a call on it. But it has never had and never will have the good fortune to attain the sure scientific method. You know, matlab, why does it really even require to? I will eliminate this. It never had and never will. First of all, is this not a conclusion? You know, how can you conclude this? What will happen? You know, never in future. I will at least cut it. I do not know even that was the next line in paragraph, but I will cut because I think it is far-fetched, even if I see it from the perspective of philosophy. And it would survive even if all the rest were swallowed up in the abyss of all destroying barbarism. You know, if this line, I was, you know, happy with this. You know, it has, it is talking, it is the oldest and it would still survive some way. I was okay. But when this line comes, even with all the rest were swallowed up in the abyss of all destroying, how on earth will I get to know what Immanuel Kant wanted to, you know, express in this? I really have no idea about it. And I think, you know, the right answer for this was D. You know, between B and E. The critical science is not supposed to the dogmatic procedure of reason in pure cognition, for the pure cognition must always be dogmatic. This is, I think, a next paragraph clearly does not talk about the dogmatic procedures of metaphysics, it does not explain anything. It talks about dogmatic procedure. What is dogmatic procedure? The things that you will have to take as axioms or, you know, granted true, that is dogmatic. When people are dogmatic, they do not listen to reason, they enforce their beliefs on you. That is dogmatic procedure. Clearly, I can eliminate it. Now, I will be confused between A and C, honestly, you know, is what I would have, you know, and some portion of D. And I think at the, you know, B, C and D. D, why? Because I would eliminate it because of this overhyped line. I would not have gone ahead with this, even if the rest were swallowed up in the abyss. Abyss is, you know, the unending, a place where you see no future, basically, for yourself. If you are in an abyss, you do not see bottomless pit, I think, is how abyss is defined. But it has never had and never been, will have good fortune. I think I eliminated it. Yet it continues to baffle mankind because of its abstraction. I think I had eliminated it already. Yes, I think I have eliminated and survived. In fact, I will eliminate even D. But I think the correct answer is E. But just look at the complexity of this paragraph. Just read it. You will try to understand what I am talking about, what I was talking about in last 5-10 minutes. Just to give you perspective, guys, I could have very well not taken this question. You know, just behaved like an ostrich, and I am quite sure you would not have questioned me for this. This is what comes. Author also imagined in this, you know, for me, honestly, I did not find any correct answer here. You choose whatever, you know, you will choose as the best possible option. Let me go forward. Yes, even I eliminated all. Supposedly, but for your kind information, when you read it, you will see this is what the answer is. I eliminated. How can I on earth know what he was thinking? How can I? This is, you know, I do not know. Even after, you know, reading that entire passage, I could not convince myself that this can be answer. Even if all rest were swallowed up in the abyss of all destroying barbarism, how can you do this, yaar? How can you do this? I at least not me. Okay, let's try to do this one. Someone is still asking for the correct answer. I told you, if you read this passage, you will mark, if you read the passage, you will end up marking D. I could not convince myself, so I cannot tell you what. For me, none of these is the answer. I can eliminate all, and I will have good logic to eliminate all. Still, if I had to mark one, I don't know what I would have marked. Now I'm already biased because I know the answer, but I'm quite sure I would not have marked D as answer. Read that entire passage. You will see, first of all, it is after 10-20, I think 10 paragraphs. It is taken from somewhere in, you know, mid of a paragraph of metaphysics. I think it was talking about the paragraph, or the passage was talking about questioning the reason. And this is funny. I really do not understand. I wish I could get into the mind or talk to the guy who had said this paper, and I want him to explain to me how and what the answer will be. Abhishek is able to convince himself that D is correct. Good for you. I do not have a problem. I think even I had proclivity towards B. Honestly, if I go back and think, if I were doing it quickly, I think I had proclivity for B. And then when I thought, I think I eliminated all. And I'm quite sure I would have never marked the answer as D, which supposedly is the correct answer for that. I'll admit it. At least now you know something about metaphysics. So expand your reading. I know, be prepared for your next test. develop that is what we when we say that you know develop your reading habit, read from various sources, that is what we wanted to say. Read something about psychology, read something about philosophy, read something about sociology. All these are important. You as a human being will also improve. Even if it is abstract, even if you do not score one mark in your IBPS exam, you will still be better off by reading all these things. Madhu, why was that question there? I also have the same question for the examiner. And if he can explain me, trust me, you know, I'll become his fan. If he can explain me why one of the options will be correct, if he does not Google the answer and explain me, I'll be really happy. Again, I'll tell you, this is, you know, difficult or weird for a different reason. I'll tell you. I think I'm getting a lot of answers. I was, you know, with D, I think Imadul is saying it is the oldest of science and it will still survive. I was perfectly fine. I would have marked D. But, you know, in the abyss of barbarism, I can't, you know, I think I still have a long way to cover before I have, you know, that kind of thought and foresight to mark that as answer. If that was only the first part and it will still continue to survive, I would have gone ahead with D. I am seeing a lot of confusion between B and D. Okay, not bad. D, I think you can eliminate. I think why will you have two decades in continued line? A new trend is seen in last decade, during the last decade or so. Will you write a sentence like that? Just think. I will eliminate D for sure. B, I will be confused. Not D. Anyone saying D, I am not really happy. Just read the line by putting D there. A new trend is seen in last decade. During the last decade, will you write something like that? You know, two times decade in a span of just 10 words. Do we see something written like that? It's not grammatically incorrect, but you know, does it sound good? Again, all those who are going with D, please see. You know, that is purposely given to entice you. By you know putting two decades closer, and that is the reason why I will eliminate it first. A new trend is seen in last decade, during the last decade or so, means you know first of all again it is in fact first of all two decades close, and then it first talks about a new trend in seen in last decade which is specific, and then it becomes vague in the very next sentence saying during the last decade or so. You know, when it was conclusive in the very first line, a new trend is seen in last decade, it should have talked about the last decade what we are seeing. The very next line becomes vague, last next decade or so. Please see D, you have to eliminate. Okay, D I can, I think, you know, immediately after reading the I can eliminate D for sure. Okay. Now again, C is beyond the scope, a lengthy and cumbersome process. Again, it's something like abyss of, you know, barbarism for, you know, me. A lengthy and cumbersome process requiring a lot of application of mind and revenue principle is ahead for the tax department of India. I think it clearly goes out of its scope. Ye thoda sa bechara divert kar gaya hai. Matlab, this is going. Now let me, you know, try to comprehend. I think B is good enough a choice. A, I am not sure about. Indian companies have lot on stake on as competition increases. Where are we talking about competition? I think even E is gone clearly. Now I think I am just left between A and B. Please try to read this too now. And I think all those you know who were confused with B, I'll have sympathy for them. Let us try to now understand what is happening here. However, it starts with however. Please know for sure. My second problem with these guys, they are lifting it from somewhere in between and they expect us to get it. Okay, still, you know, this word however will help me. It is possible for non-resident entity, so that means this however can signify two things. Either, you know, the sentences before it would have talked about resident entity, or it is talking about the non-resident entity and something which is being talked about opposite of that. So it is possible, please try to understand what I am saying. This, however, is bringing contrast. It is possible that the non-resident entity, so previous lines before it would have talked about resident entity, or it would have talked about, it is possible that the non-resident entity may have a business connection with the resident Indian entity. So either there should have been contrast with this part, may have a business, they will not have business connection is what would have been talked about in previous sentences. These are the only two possible cases. Okay, let us move forward. In such cases, the resident Indian entity could be treated as permanent establishment of the non-resident entity. Now they are giving some solution. What is happening here? Dash, during the last decade or so, India has, you know, seen a steady growth of outsourcing of business processes by non-resident or foreign companies to IT-enabled countries. Again, explaining what is happening. Such entities, either branches or associated enterprise for the foreign enterprise of an enterprise, the non-resident entity or the foreign company will be liable to tax in India only if the IT-enabled BPO in India constitute the permanent establishment. Now let us try to understand first what is happening here. There are two things. No, you have this IT-enabled, you know, or the companies which are operating in, say, companies in India, okay, these are IT companies foreign, okay, these are Indian companies. Now there can be two kind of relation. These IT companies can work with these companies in India whose major job is not the IT, but they can help these IT firm by having some synergy, by providing some cheap infrastructural support to these guys, and then these guys will not be seen as their counterpart or their establishment. And this is one scenario. Second part is, these guys, if they have related business to what these guys are already having, then these guys can be treated as their subsidiary. Okay, these guys in the company in India which are helping these IT firms are also in the same business. Two cases, either they are in the same business or they are not. If they are not, then they are treated as separate entity. But if they are having the same business, they will be treated as, you know, their partners, and they will be taxed. For that, you have various rules which are supposed to come up now. It is possible that non-resident entity may have business connection with resident Indian entity. So these, you know, having connection with resident Indian entity. In such case, the resident entities could be treated as permanent establishment. Now, if they have this, you know, if they are in the same line of business, they can be treated as their permanent establishment. Okay. For them, you do not have the rule, or that is what, you know, being talked about. And now this permanent establishment is what is being elaborated. What would have been the previous sentence? These IT companies, when they are not in the same line, they will not be treated as this, and hence these guys will not be taxed. Now what is happening, because of the new arrangement, these guys will be taxed because they are, you know, working with the permanent establishment. And what we do not know about this permanent establishment, how they will be taxed in under the tax law. This is a long story. I hope you are able to understand. Let me try to explain this in Hindi also. Do tarah ki company, ek videshi, ek bhartiya, theek hai? Bahar ki jo IT company hai, wo bhartiya agar company hai, jo uski madad kar sake, agar wo IT mein na ho to, us tarah ki company ke saath kya hoga, ki ye jo bahar ki company hai, unke upar koi tax nahi lagta hai. Agar ye wali jo Bharat ki company jinke saath wo milke kaam kar rahe hain, uske bare mein agar ye aapko pata hona chahiye tha, ye text aapko nahi bata raha hai. लेकिन अगला लाइन ये एविडेंट मतलब करता है, आपको पूरा ठीक से पढ़ना पड़ेगा और समझना पड़ेगा. लेकिन ये जो बाहर की कंपनी है, भारत की उसी कंपनी के साथ काम कर रहा है जिनका बिजनेस लाइन, द वे ऑफ वर्किंग और द डोमेन ऑफ वर्किंग इज सेम, तब इनको, जो बाहर की कंपनीज है, उनको भारत वाली कंपनियों को भी अपना एक परमानेंट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ट्रीट करना पड़ेगा. अगर इनको आप अपना परमानेंट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ट्रीट कर रहे हो, तो आपको भी टैक्स देना पड़ेगा. और अब चूंकि ये अब नया फिनोमेना है, पहले क्या होता था, कि बाहर वाली कंपनीज जो भारत की जो आईटी कंपनीज है वो बोलते थे हमारा नॉन रिलेटेड बिजनेस है, हम उनसे सिर्फ हेल्प ले रहे हैं, वो बच जाते थे और इनके ऊपर सिर्फ टैक्स लगता था, ये लोग अपना नॉन रिलेटेड बिजनेस करके दिखा देते थे। लेकिन अब यहाँ पर इन कंपनीज के ऊपर भी टैक्स लगेगा और ये जो नई कंपनी जो अब परमानेंट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट की तरह जिनकी मजबूरी हो जाएगी इनको दिखाने की, इनके ऊपर भी रूल बनेगा। एंड हेंस द ऑप्शन ए वुड बी करेक्ट। इफ यू डिड नॉट नो अबाउट इट योर चॉइस वुड हैव बीन बी एंड आई वुड हैव sympathized with you, you know, absolutely no problem, you know, even B makes perfect sense if you did not know the background, okay, you got confused between A and B, I am totally with you, I do not know how IBPS expects us to know all this, okay, good for us, let's quickly do, okay, this is, just read this, you will laugh, this is again, you know, even in our finance major, only few guys who actually took hardcore finance would have, you know, read about risk aggregation, you know, what are risk aggregation, what are asset class, you are expected to know this, okay, just let us try, I think all 150 odd 160 of you who are bearing with me, you know, let us kind of just complete these two questions also. I am taking it just to give you a feel because these questions have appeared in your examination. Guys, please try to understand, these are, I do not know why they have chose to put it, but it will be equally difficult, you can take my word for it, even I have found it difficult, very difficult indeed, and you know, even all the CAT aspirants will have a hard time cracking this question, so do not worry about it. There will be few, jinka us din tukka lag jaye, they will, you know, get, you know, few more marks, hardly improbable, so don't get bothered about, we told you we will cover everything and that is the only reason why we are covering it. We are true to our word, that is why I'm covering. I'm really not, you know, enjoying telling you at the end of the day that, you know, these are difficult and, you know, these are likely questions which you can also leave in your examination. So please bear with me, all of you who are, you know, still sticking with me. It's just an eye-opener, you know, all those who take English very lightly and when we ask you to work on your English, if you think we are, you know, some way being prejudiced to guys who are not comfortable in English, please see for yourself, is all I can say. Please, you know, I love this attitude. Arvind says, answer for sure is D. I love it. Can you, you know, Arvind, if you are so sure, can you just explain what are asset classes? Can you just explain in brief for me? What is risk aggregation and asset class? If you can explain to me, I will understand that you have really thought over this question. I think not even a single fluke also in this question so far. Okay, finally, I think Namita has the first correct answer and then Ankit, that's A. Now, okay, let me try to explain what these things are. I did not even intend to cover this in our general awareness section. Risk aggregation and, you know, asset class are really high level topics here. I don't think they will be asking it even in interview, but they have, you know, chosen to put it in your mains examination. Aggregation of risk is sometimes quite new to banks in India. Now, this is altogether a new concept. I think Basel 3 or 4, will have more stress on this. What it says is you do not talk about risk individually. You also talk about, you have to aggregate the risk per se. I'll give you an example for you to, let me just come back on screen. What is risk aggregation before to understand what is the concept? So what generally bank does is, they will say I have 10,000 customers, and by these 10,000 customers, I'll have maximum risk appetite of say 10,000 rupees per se. Okay, what risk aggregation says, that is not enough. All you have to do is just imagine on a very bad day, like the Swan event, or the Black Swan event, which is popularly known as, your banks can go bankrupt. So you have to aggregate those risks, and you have to be prepared for the worst of the scenario. So you can't say that my individual risks are very less, so I am safe as a bank. On a worst possible day, all these risks can, you know, come together, and it can happen in a day. So you have to give me your aggregated risk score. All these small risks have to be aggregated and given to me with some margin, where, you know, their probability of happening will have to be accounted for. This is risk aggregation as a concept. That is what all companies do. Any company in trading, any company into supply chain business, all banks, all private funded bank, any bank which is into, you know, trading or into currency currency exchange or giving securities, all your hedge fund, etc., will be very aware of all this. They have to do risk aggregation, because you'll never know where, you know, a bad time hit you from. So that is the concept of risk aggregation. Next is the appropriate asset class. Asset class in its concept means, you know, it is indicating about three things basically. That talks about the equity you have, it talks about the bond or the loans you have, and it talks about the raw capital, you know, the thing which is the liquid money that you have. That are the three asset classes that, you know, we talk about. So what is this paragraph talking about? This concept is altogether new, because aap bas kaam chala lete ho, that, you know, all overall my risk is low, so it is low, but that will not be sufficient. We have seen that, you know, in this global economy, when the world is becoming more interconnected, we are likely to lose focus, and if you are not aware about all the risks that we have, you might be, you know, taken aback. That is why it becomes important to understand all risk, and to put it systemized, it should be calculated, and, you know, the worst possible scenario should be accounted for. So your risk appetite basis, you know, if your risk, overall risk comes to say 10,000 crore rupees, you should be prepared to take that hit, and you should also be ready to know ki aap, where will you take that hit in equity, bond, anyways you can't take that hit, how much of the capital surplus you have. If you don't have, you will not be able to work like that. That is the entire story when you read this aggregation of risk and asset class is all about. I hope I have, you know, explained you. I do not know again why this will form a part of your question. So let me just now move out of the, I think it was easier if you do not get into the nitty gritties. What gives me the hint here, let me try to solve this question now. Aggregation of risk is something somewhat new concept in bank. While some bank have started thinking, okay, and then it has tried to explain what they have started thinking. Putting integrated framework, integrated risk policies, using CBS, you know, is the core banking solution. So all the risk of the bank are, you know, the central zonal bank will know about all the risk. Technological integration, the effort required is beyond such requirement. Now it is saying they have already started taking this. This is not sufficient. All the risk aggregation concept and appropriate risk class I have, you know, already explained to you. Capital allocation about how much would be based on such strategies. Ki aap kitna risk lena chahte hain? How much is your risk? What is your risk appetite? So ab if you really want to solve this question, it makes perfect sense. You know, there are, you know, quite new to some banks in India. While some banks have started thinking it, most banks are still, you know, in process of analyzing it. Let's see the B. Most banks have already integrated. Now only they say, while some banks have just started it, they have not even talked about how can most banks have already integrated it in their function and is already satisfactory. They have just told that they have just started using this concept, which would in long run prove to be growth impeding. Why will they do, and why will, you know, financial world as a whole suggest something which will impede growth? Of risk aggregation, which is generally a new concept to
is this not specifically, you know, explicitly, you know, stated in the bank? Why are you mentioning this again? On the expected line of regulation condition written down in the manual of bank. What is manual of bank? At least I have never, you know, heard of. You have RBI guidelines is what I have heard for all such things. Manual of bank will be for the employees and not for the policy decision. So if you say this question was relatively easy, if I go by the elimination method, but I have to still understand what is it talking about, right? Capital allocation and risk aggregation, I think I have explained you. Let me now move to the last question. I think we have had enough. Okay, we have already passed 2 hours. I really appreciate you guys. I hope you have learned something new. At least you have understood the importance of English language per se in your chances of getting this job. But don't get demotivated because, you know, of these difficult questions. Trust me, no one will have a clue of all this question. You know, even after practicing a lot, they will only go by their hunches. So you are absolutely safe. Don't get perturbed by seeing this question in examination. If you put in some extra effort, you will know you are better off. All the hunches that you will have, you will be making more calculated risk and hence will have more chances of getting it right. Let us just close with this question. Okay, this is another trap. Just go back. Aggregation of risk. How do you know from where this passage has been taken? Where was this passage written in 2016 or this passage was written in 2010 when people were still talking about modernization? Ankita had a valid doubt, but this is a trap. Now, you know, while some banks have started thinking in the line and they have, you know, as well as CBS solution, so you can clearly guess this passage has been written at time when CBS solution had just been started. Please try to understand. Don't use your current knowledge. Please restrain yourself to the limit of the information provided in the passage. It is a trap. Okay, let me just quickly close this. After 2 years of high inflation, okay, again, I'll explain this also. High inflation moderated in later part of 2011-12 in response to the past monetary tightening. Again, a very interesting concept. I think this we will definitely discuss. And growth deceleration. High inflation had adverse consequences on welfare and on saving and investment. It happens all the time, particularly household saving and financial assets. The most serious consequences of inflation is dash. As growth slowed down in part due to high inflation, it further reduced the welfare of the common man through adverse impact on employment and income. So what it is talking about, okay? Let me just again come back. So what it is talking about, a scenario where the industry was hit by drought. Hit by drought and, you know, the monsoon was bad. Again, the prices of the commodities increased. This is known as supply constraint of the goods, which is pushing the prices up. It's very difficult to constrain. If you have the demand induced, it is still controlled. If you have supply side constraint, it is very difficult to control because you had a very poor crop because of two monsoon. Therefore, you know, prices of the commodity started increasing and hence the inflation increases. What does RBI do when inflation increases? It tries to increase the interest rate. What does that in turn do? Why it is increasing the interest rate? Because if interest rate are high, people are more likely to save in their, you know, banks. And, you know, if they do not increase the rate, if say RBI interest rate or, you know, bank interest rate at 6 and 7 and my inflation goes 7%, if I am keeping my money in my pocket or, you know, at that percent in bank, it is basically giving you negative return. So RBI will be forced to at least match, at least it should have zero. That is the, you know, policy formulation. That is what real interest should not ideally go below a zero. That is what RBI policymaker will think. So if it is 5%, let me give you at least 1% real interest, which is the incentive for you to put the money in bank. Otherwise, no one will put money in bank, right? Now, what happens when inflation goes up? Now, RBI tightens the monetary policy. Tightening of monetary policy means just one thing. It increases the rate. That is how, that is what is mean by tightening. The when rates are increased, people will now try to save. But at the same time, if investment goes up, I told you the cost of capital goes up, and hence the industries will start saving less. They will invest lesser and lesser in newer job creation and newer opportunities. So that is a vicious cycle. But you will have to do it. RBI, that is the only choice when the inflation starts shooting above the roof. So that is the background. That is what I have just explained you. Now let us see what it is talking about. So saving, investment, monetary tightening, what happened because of poor monsoon. I have discussed all that in great detail. Now, high inflation had adverse consequences on welfare and on saving of investment. Clearly explained, you are basically getting negative return on your savings and investment. Particularly household saving and financial asset, aap agar kahin par dal rahe hain, agar inflation has gone up, basically you are getting negative interest. The most serious consequences of inflation is, now, its destructive allocation impact on industry that were lately coming up, is it what it is talking about? It is true. Please try to understand, this is true, but is it what the sentence is talking about? It is talking about the adverse effect on employment and income. It is talking about the consequences and welfare of particularly the household saving. They are talking about more common people. The problem that is being talked about here is all the impact which is happening on the common people. Yes, negative impact on the rich and high profile people, clearly out of picture, right? What is talking about? It's talking about the common people. It is talking about the industries getting shut down or having problem, in turn affecting the normal people. Then I would have taken this, but this is just talking about the factories and having detrimental effect on the allocation impact on the factories. That is why I am just keeping it in hold. Its adverse distributional impact, again, distributional impact is an interesting term. Adverse distributional impact means, in process, if you follow you formulate some law, is it equally affecting everything? Say for example, the rich countries are talking about climate change. When they are talking about climate change, is it having adverse distributional impact on the developing countries? That is also how it is used. Adverse distributional impact, once you formulate a policy, is it having any adverse impact on a certain section of the society? You have to be very careful when you form such policies. On the poor people without social security and pensioner, it is definitely reflecting the mood of the people, the poor who are being suffering. They do not have any money. They are now getting kicked out of the job because people are not ready to employ. Costs are already going up and these guys are not getting job and hence will not be even able to buy their necessity. Okay, I hope this is clear. It's wayward consequences on the public distribution system meant for the poor. Why will public distribution system will not be affected? Please try to understand. This is already ration shops which are already allocated thing by the government, and hence this one will absolutely have no issues on the public distribution system. Please try to understand, this is unwanted. It's unfavorable bearing on day-to-day commodities that are used by common man. This is again true. Please try to understand, A is true, E is true. But if you have to choose between A, C and E, looking at the tone of passage, we are talking about all this tightening of monetary policy. Who were the people who were least benefited and why this happened? Because of the adverse distributional impact. And hence, I think option C should be the correct answer. I hope I have explained this. Okay, with this, I think I had kept even the CAT question. I'll just scroll through them, try to attempt these question also. Again, these were again controversial as well, because the passage from where they are lifted, CAT in some of the question did not have the same answer. Okay, this was the actual text also I have given. If you want to attempt all these questions, you can do that. again, you know, very good, say, for improving your reading habit, but somewhat difficult. I think that is what these guys have been also inspired by. Whenever, if you choose this question, it has to be difficult. Okay, so with that, all you guys who, you know, stuck with me, I hope you at least understood few things. Please be rest assured that you are not disadvantaged. Most of these guys, unless he's really, you know, all his life he has done nothing but philosophy and sociology and all those subjects, and he has excellent, you know, reading habit, then I think he would have been already placed. He would not be competing. So don't worry about it. Don't get demotivated. But it is an eye-opener. This is a great topic. Why? Because it, you know, gives you confidence. Or say it encourages you to go for next, develop your next level of reading. Don't get, you know, overconfident by thinking that whatever reading that you have developed will be sufficient. We will all be lifelong learner. That is what these kind of passages, you know, makes us modest. And I'm really very happy taking this passage. I hope the same message is conveyed to you guys also. Please take in the spirit of learning. Don't get perturbed by it. At the same time, get confidence and, you know, get encouraged that you should go to the, you still have long way to improve your language skills. Okay, with that, I will just call it a day. Thank you very much. It was a tough day today. I appreciate all you guys who stuck with me. Thank you very much.